This is a situation we looked at in another lesson, but I'd like to talk about it this time from a slightly different perspective. I want to talk about how you compare rates of change and initial amounts. Now, the rate of change, it's already highlighted here for this table as +3. That's the amount of change each time per +1, or per unit change of the inputs. So we do 3 divided by 1, which is 3. So the rate is 3. The initial amount, that's what you get for an input of 0, which is 4. Now on the graph, the rate of change is the slope. And that's the same ratio as the 3 divided by 1, which is 3. And all you're doing is you're doing the same calculation. The amount of change is the amount up or down, and then per distance across, or per distance between the inputs. In this case, it's divided by 1, so 3 divided by 1 equals 3. So this m is the same rate of change as in the table. And the initial amount is this y-intercept right here, which is at 4, which is the same initial amount as in the table. So if you were comparing which one would be greater, you'd take this value for the y-intercept, take this initial value for the table, and compare from there. Same thing with rate of change. Find the rate of change here by dividing this 3 divided by 1. Same thing here. 3 divided by 1 is a slope. So there's your rate of change. Function equation. Here's your rate. Here's the initial. So if you're comparing different representations, you just look at the rates and the initial values. I mean, it's just different ways of saying the same thing in this case. So you have 4 here for the initial, 4 here for the initial, 4 here for the initial. The rate's 3, 3, 3. How about in words? Multiply by 3, that's the rate of change. Add 4, that's the initial amount. Now you want to be careful right here, this function in words. It says multiply by 3 and add 4. And it should say to the input. As you look at this graph, you're not really multiplying this previous value by 3 and adding 4. You're taking the input, let's say for this guy is 1, multiply by 3, and 1 times 3 is 3, so that brings you up here, and then you're adding 4 more, which brings you up here to 7. So the number of people is the input, multiply by 3, and then add 4. But the important point here is that you can find the rate and the initial amount in any one of these representations so you can compare them intelligently.